This video is proudly brought to you by Hovatek. Hovatek. Just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'm going to explain how to install VCOM drivers for your Mediatek smartwatch on your Windows PC. The smartwatches tend to vary in chipsets. For Mediatek smartwatches, you have some running on feature chipsets like the MT62XX, which are feature chipsets, and you have some running on the more recent one like the MT65XX, MT67X, and the rest. And what you should know about this variation in chips is that the feature chipsets have their own kind of drivers and how you install the drivers, whereas the more recent chips have their own kind of drivers and how you install them. So I'm going to be going through the two techniques here. For I don't know what kind of smartwatch you have, so I'm going to be showing you how to install the drivers for either scenario. Okay, the first thing you're going to need is your Mediatek drivers. I have my drivers here, which you can download from the website. We have an article on this same topic, so just visit the website, download the necessary drivers, and you can tag along. All right, after you've downloaded your drivers, I have my VCOM drivers here, which is for the newer chipsets, while I have the one for featured smartwatches, that's the MT62XX and the rest. Okay, now let me go through installing the ones for more recent chips. Okay, now what you want to do is to ensure you have disabled driver signature verification if you're using Windows 8 and above. Okay, and this is because the drivers you're going to be installing are unsigned. Although some of them are signed, but a good number of them are unsigned drivers. So for you to be able to install them, you need to disable your signature verification for Windows 8 and above. We already have a guide on how to do that. You can check our website and our YouTube channel. You can follow that guide and disable your signature verification. So once that is done, what you need to do is to launch Device Manager. Device Manager. We are going to be installing the drivers. The first driver I'm going to install is for the MT65XX and the rest and above, the newer chips. Okay, if your smartwatch is that kind. Now what you need to do is to, once you open Device Manager, you just highlight on any item, then you click on Action, Add Legacy Hardware, next. Install the hardware that I manually select from a list, next. Next, Hard Disk, Browse. Now what you want to do is to navigate to the location of your VCOM drivers. Mine is in the Hovatek folder. I just joined both drivers under the Mediatek USB VCOM drivers. Okay, this will not be in the same folder as this when you extract. Okay, just to make that clear. So in your Mediatek USB VCOM drivers, this is what you are going to open, this drivers folder, USB VCOM driver. Now if yours is an XP or Vista, you select this. And if it's Windows 7 and above, you open the Windows 7 folder. I'm using a Windows 10 PC, so I'm going to select the Windows 7 folder. Now this is for 32, this is for 64 bits. To know which your PC is, just right click on My Computer. In this case, mine is this PC. You right click, select Properties, and you can see your under system type. Mine is 64 bits. Okay, so I'm going to come back here, select the one for 64 bits, and then click Open. Okay, and then I select Mediatek Prolar USB VCOM port, next. Next, and then you just wait for the drivers to get installed. Okay, this was installed, you can click Finish. So if your smartwatch is of the newer chip, the MT65XX and above, you've just installed drivers for that and you can go ahead. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to install the one for feature smartwatches, that is the MT62XX, and you know, the older versions of the older smartwatches running on older chips. Okay, All right, back to my Mediatek VCOM folder. Okay, Mediatek Smartwatch driver, this is for the older ones. So here you have your CDC driver, you have your MS USB COM port driver, MTK USB driver, and this is for Windows 10 users. So I already have this installed. I'm a Windows 10 user. It's the same thing as the USB VCOM driver I just installed. It's about the same thing, so I don't need to go through that. I will just be walking you through manually installing the CDC driver and automatically installing these two ones. For the CDC driver, I just come back here to Device Manager. Since I'm going to be manually installing that, I just highlight any item. Same process as what I did for the VCOM drivers. Just the same process. In fact, it's the same thing for manually installing a driver. The only thing that varies is what you, the file, the driver file you select, just what varies. It's the same process for manually installing drivers. Here I select CDC. Now it's important you note that you can see it's just about, I have my Mediatek Prelude USB VCOM Android, but here I just select my CDC. Okay, Android gadget VCOM, and I click on next. You might not have to install all these drivers. That is one. Okay, here at this point you need to select install this driver anyway. You might not have to install all these drivers I'm installing. Okay, the reason why I'm just trying to show you, the reason why I'm installing all of this is just to make you know how to go about it. In case you install one driver and the software is still not detecting your smartwatch, okay, you install the next driver, you try again. If it's still not detected, you try again. You could keep trying several drivers till you find just the right one, okay, for your chipset or for your smartwatch. So it's not like you have to necessarily install all of this, but I'm starting with the most basic ones, the ones I think you really need to install, which is your VCOM drivers and then your CDC driver. All right, this is installed. So I have my CDC installed. Now you're going to automatically install these ones. This one doesn't need manual installation. Just double click install driver, run anyway. Yes, when prompted. So that is done. It's easy as that. The next one is this install driver, run anyway. Okay, this one has a compatibility issue. So what you need to do is install using compatibility settings. Yes. All right, so install the driver for Windows Vista successful. So when you, for this particular one, when you have that error, just select install using compatibility settings. Sometimes you tend to have that issue. So so far I've installed the drivers, we should, yes, it's worked perfectly. So far I've installed the drivers, which should work for your more recent chips. That is the smart running on more recent chips. I said the ones running on older chips, so you should have a detection after installing the drivers the way I've installed them. But in some cases you still might find out that after installing all these drivers, the tool is still not detecting your smartwatch. Now I'm going to show you a trick, a very important trick, which could really be the game changer for you. It has helped me a lot of times, so I'm going to share it with you. Now when you've installed many drivers for your smartwatch, especially for your Mediatek smartwatch, it is talking about Mediatek, when you have installed many drivers for your Mediatek smartwatch and it's still not getting detected, what you need to do is that you need to trigger the PC to install the smartwatch's driver from the smartwatch. Okay, now to do that, what you need to do is to take out the battery from the smartwatch. Okay, it also works for mobile phones, also Mediatek phones too. It's a way you can force driver installation. In fact, force compatible driver installation, let me put it that way. Alright, so you are going to take out the battery from the smartwatch. Okay, now without the battery in the smartwatch, you hold the, when after removing the battery, you hold the power button. Don't forget, it also works for smartphones. But with smartphones, you might hold the volume down button sometimes. Sometimes it might be the volume up. Sometimes it might be the power and the volume up. Sometimes it might be the power and the volume down. It tends to vary. But either way, you remove the battery to hold the button combo. For this smartwatch, you're going to remove the battery. Then you hold down the power button. Now, while holding the power button, you are going to now connect the smartwatch to the PC via USB. Still holding the power button without a battery in it. Now you can see this. So just leave it this way to keep installing. So I have a constant connection and disconnection here. So that's good. Yours might actually vary. In some cases, you have it can keep installing. Then you're going to see COM ports. We're going to see a COM port driver being installed. In this case, maybe because I've done it already before on this tab. All right, so that's why I'm not having a COM port message. But for you, you might have the COM port message pop up on your screen. Let me disconnect. So in your case, what you need to do is, after you're installing driver several times and you still can't find the one for your smartphone, just take out the battery, hold the power button, then you connect it to the PC, all right, and just keep holding it. So that is going to install the smartwatch's driver on your PC, and then you should have detection. So having gone through this is just what you need to do. These are the steps you need to follow to install drivers on your PC for your MediaTek smartwatch.